need some chum chum, motherfucker.
He's asking me for titty pics, and I'm like, hey, send me a picture.
I mean, you won't even have to really deny it. Not saying you look like a man or anything, but it's 2019. You can just be like, hey, don't judge me. It's 2019. I just leave it at that.
I've considered doing that and just getting weird with them, but I think some of them would enjoy it if it wouldn't make it worse. So, if it wouldn't make them run away.
You know, I dealt with that one time. At a fucking strip club in Stockton, I had a dude, like, and it's crazy, because he was one of the most gangster dudes there. We always were having to stop him from bringing his gun in the club, everything else. One night, he gets all drunk, and he asked me, he's like, dead serious, but he's like, hey, you know where I find chicks with dicks? And I just laughed. I was like, no, I pretend people don't do that. I thought he was joking. He got all sad about it. He's like, boy, you judging me now, bro? I was like, yeah, kind of, I guess, and there's no such thing as chicks with dicks. There's just dudes with fake titties.
Yeah.
It's true as fuck. You know, I can't help it. They had the strain on sale today, and I got a whole bunch of them on sale. Figured I'd chew it out and get to go for the sales, you know?
There's just certain things that you should get
told.
That strain is one of them.
Man, I want to see this in a dab.
It would probably be yummy.
It sounds yummy, but it makes you, like, I haven't had a weed make me choke since about a fucking, probably 17 years old. This shit choked the fuck out of me while I first hit it.
Yeah, but as long as you don't do, like, a huge dab, like, I don't like dabbing to begin with. Like, I've done it a few times when I was, like, working out in Oregon and all that, but, not, like, I would do it as a regular thing. I like to vape them. Those are, like, but, like,
They got a DMT vape now.
I saw that. Denver. We have to go to, like, we're going to have this conversation now. Yes, the drugs, like, they hit better when they're legal. That's all I'm saying. I want to go shrooming in Denver. There we go.
Well, shroom in Denver, but I'm wearing all my Raiders gear. Hell yeah.
Okay, I'm going to go to Denver. And you can stay, like, on the left coast. I'll go to Denver by myself.
No. You want this room without your business partner. That's not cool. I think that's in our contracts.
We might have to revise contracts. I'm going to be getting an email after the show. Like, it's literally my thing. With a little edit going, all drugs must be done together.
Really, it's true. We all just hold out the shrooms, man. I've been looking for shrooms forever. Because my goal is I'm going to go live on shrooms.
Any out there. I'm, like, really surprised you can't find any out there. With as, like, rainy as it is, you would think that, like, it would be a good area for them.
I found, like, expensive edible mushrooms, like ones that fucking I've sold and shit, the restaurants buy and everything else. Like, you can find exotic mushrooms all day. They even have people finding truffles and shit out here. You can't find magic mushrooms, though. Some bullshit. Maybe you fucking ate them all.
Probably. I don't blame the hippies. I don't blame the hippies at all.
Because, like, I want to do a bunch of shrooms one day, like, eat an eighth of them, probably an hour before I start the show, and then I'm going to start the show and just gradually see how weird we get.
I'm not sure if I would do that. I'm going to take off probably going to change my email. I think we need an email. We need a complaint line. So it doesn't come directed to me, and it just gets an automated message back going, yes, I know he's an asshole.
Yeah.
I'm trying to say that to a few people.
We'll do it, we'll do it.
Me on ID.
We'll do it. We'll do suckit.com or, I mean, suckit at ceoradio.com. Don't type in suckit.com, guys. You'll get some weird shit.
And you would know that.
I mean, I don't know that. I'm going to Google it after the show.
I know you're
going to
let you guys know in the morning.
I'll let you guys know before we take our fucking time off.
Look at what I found.
If you're like, where was the CEO for a week? I was on sucker.com, jacking off.
That was like a little off there.
Fire. Fuck, I'm grown. No fucks. Everyone jacks off. That lady in Texas trying to outlaw it, but you know what? No. Then you know what we'll have? They tried outlaw alcohol, and they had the prohibition pioneers. We'll have the masturbation pioneers out there. People are jacking off above the law.
What are they going to do about, like, females masturbating them? Like, is that going to be against the law?
No, the lady just wants to fucking stop dudes from fucking jacking it. Y'all can revel it in all you want in Texas, I guess. That's bullshit, isn't it?
No, I'm here with that. I mean,
at the end of the day, though, if they let it do it, if we let them do it in Texas, they're going to do it everywhere, because this Rosie O'Donnell looking dyke broad about there in Texas trying to fucking make it worldwide. They're going to start trying to find, they just want $100 to jack off. If you're paying $100 to jack off, you might as well go fucking get yourself a little $60 hooker on Backpage or something. I'll pay $100 to jack off.
Get a girlfriend.
Yeah. Well, I mean, yeah, for the guys that don't have girlfriends, a lot of them don't. You know, I had a buddy of mine, he always told me he wasn't ashamed that he rented fucking sex instead of buying it. And he said, you don't pay him for the sex, you pay him to leave afterwards.
Well, that's true.
You pay him to not try to go to Costco with you and shit the next day. Fucking. You know, I can understand. I mean, I still can't pay for it, but still, I understand why people do. I almost paid for it like 3 years ago. But the bride gave me an attitude, and then she went in the bathroom, so then I left with my money, her money, and her cigarettes.
Because she got an attitude with
you? Yeah, she has kind of a stank-ass attitude, like I wasn't getting dressed fast enough or some shit. I'm like, damn, I was just rushing the motherfucker out here. I probably smoked a cigarette and shit. She's like, I'm going to use the restroom. You better be done. I go, all right, whatever. So she left her purse there. I'm like, fine, we'll take my money, and we'll take your money, and I need that pack of cigarettes, too. Bitch.
Oh, wow.
And, you know, I devoted after that, but you know what? That's why that life wasn't for me. I figured, okay, I'll try it one time. Nope, it wasn't for me. Can't handle it. So I'm expecting, like, fish, no, make a sandwich and shit. I'm going to smoke a cigarette. You go cook something? Like, what the fuck? You want me to leave?
Yeah, you got to go make your own sandwich.
Fucking bullshit.
I can't even remember if you took the mayo out of it.
Yeah, that was fucked up earlier. I was smoking, and I went to make a sandwich, and I went and looked in my fridge for the mayonnaise. I'm like, what the fuck is it? And I'm looking for like 5 minutes, and I look over on the counter. That shit's on the counter with the bologna and the cheese already took out.
Yeah, this is why you need somebody to make a sandwich
for you. For real. I was married to a professional sandwich maker for fucking 6 years and didn't make a goddamn sandwich.
Like I said earlier, that should have been a sign.
Yeah. true. You know, a little life advice. I know we got kids out there listening. Don't marry a chick that has face tattoos, felony warrants, or a drug addiction. If you meet her during a drug deal, don't marry her.
Yeah, or a dude with a neck tattoo. Don't do it.
I almost had a neck tattoo at one point. Neck tattoos used to be the shit back in the day.
Back in the day. Like, and then they turn out to be assholes. So fine.
I mean, it kind of makes sense. I'm an asshole, so yeah, it makes sense. I almost got a neck tattoo, but the homeboy ended up not having enough heat that day. I was going to get 209 across my neck.
I would have never even worked with you.
Oh my God.
I would have never even worked with you. I would have, no. You're gonna trigger some shit, and I'm gonna get angry, and I'm gonna end up getting you in there. There's a chance of that anyway, but,
even when I saw, like, when I was in high school, chicks used to fucking, I remember starting in high school with the tramp stamps. That's when it first started for me. It was in high school when they'd get their name on their, they started out with the temporary tattoo to get their name on their fucking lower back. So that way those guys would know their names the next day.
I had a tramp stamp, but.
Is it your name though?
No, it's not.
See, that's different. That's artwork. There's some girls that have their, like a lot of girls, especially out in Stockton and shit. I mean, much love everyone in Stockton, but y'all know we got some raggedy broads out in Stockton. They all got their name tramp stamped on them, just so you remember their name the next day. You know, we'll get him some songs, though.